my brother Starker, who really is the most admired of anybody in his generation in his field, was not successful in college. And I made up my mind I was going to counter that. I was going to be the best student I could be.
Luna Leopold combined his training and expertise in engineering, meteorology, geology, and hydrology to develop the scientific foundation for the field of fluvial geomorphology, the study of how rivers are shaped and influenced by their surrounding landscapes. He authored some 200 articles and books, many of which remain widely used in teaching and fieldwork today. Like his brother Starker, Luna Leopold was elected to the National Academy of Sciences.
My brother Luna was particularly interested in water problems and became, in my unbiased opinion, a very important hydrologist and worked a lot in restoring river systems all over the country. In fact, Luna had a great deal to do with the fact that they did not build a major airport in the Everglades, because Luna gave them one statement. He said, "If you build this airport in the Everglades, Miami will have no water." And that took care of it.
He did experiments in arroyos of northern New Mexico of painting rocks and placing them in the arroyo bottom and coming back after a storm and see where the rocks went. And so he really started looking at what's really happening in a stream as opposed to, you know, what we think is going to happen.
I was 29 or something when I was elected into public office, and so I had never taken a hydrology course. And so the first thing we did was to get Luna's little book. It was a paperback book, a primer on water, and just study it. For our generation, there really was nothing around except for Luna's primer on water. That was our little Bible, you know, to read.
My father said to me, why are you an engineer? You're a biologist. And I said, well, I tell you, Dad, I feel I have to be an engineer because the kind of work I'm going to go into, I have to talk to engineers and I have to be one. The reason I was in that field is because my father told me the soil erosion was a very important problem in the land. And I said, okay, I'm going to be a soil erosion expert.
Because of him, we paid attention to that river in an incredibly detailed and intimate manner every time we ran the Colorado. You know, we'd talk about what Luna said.
When I testified before the Supreme Court, the Salt Lake newspaper had a headline about 2 inches high saying, Leopold takes 2 million acre feet out of the Colorado River. And all of the state engineers descended on Washington demanding that I be fired. And after thinking about it, the Secretary of Interior called a press conference, and he said, I was never invited. He said, the Geological Survey is here to give us facts. And Leopold just gave us facts. You may not agree with him, but they were facts. And he said, he's not going to get fired.
And then later, Luna put out a book with Thomas Gunn called Water and Environmental Planning. So I'd say those two books are as crucial as Aldo's books were to people interested in land conservation. The next generation took Luna's books and used it understanding the nature of water and watersheds. And there was really no one else writing about that.